One thing I want to touch on that really pisses me off that nobody's talking about. I've now listened to a lot of experts talking about this, and I've read a ton of articles and blah, 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 blah. There is a common theme that everyone's talking about. Funding for prevention and pandemic relief. You will hear people saying things like, we spend X billions of dollars on our defense budget and we spend next to nothing on viral disease prevention or systems for handling pandemics. They're absolutely right. You know what else we don't spend any money on? Getting the population healthy. None, zilch, zero, nada. Guys like me, the musician from Nashville, have to spend every waking moment of our lives desperately trying to educate the public and correct the misinformation we've been teaching the population for decades. Think about it. Guys like me, virtually zero risk of being taken out by something like coronavirus. How much better off would we all be right now if we took, I don't know, like 1% of the trillions of dollars spent caring for the sick and invested it in education and prevention? What a crazy idea. A crazy idea that will, in all likelihood, never happen. Remember, everybody, marketing companies rule the world. Money does not rule the world. Marketing companies who decide where the money goes rule the world. And yes, your favorite news channel that you are convinced is unbiased is a fucking marketing company. It is not a news station. The moment that you believe that is not true, you are already completely fucked and you fall into the category of sheeple. Yes, what I call sheeple, okay? Don't be sheeple. Don't. I'm gonna stop on this particular topic before I get too ranty about corruption and the way the economy actually works. I want to share the way that I see this from what I will call a natural selection standpoint, which is quite scary. Let me catch my breath, everybody. I get a little bit heated about these things, okay? I wanna talk to you about virus intelligence. This might be a little out there for some of you, and I need you to understand that I'm a little out there for some of you. I believe plants have consciousness, right? But a virus is a living thing that wants to survive and reproduce. This is why we're dealing with the fifth strain in a family of coronaviruses, plural. It is a living thing. I'll give you an example of this. If we look at the history of agriculture, and I've talked about this in other podcasts over the years, we've talked about domesticated grains. But if you really look at what happened, particularly to the health and the health of humans and the amount of land we now devote to the reproduction of grains, one could argue, and Michael Pollan has argued this, that grains actually domesticated humans. Grains are one of the most successful living things of all time in terms of their ability to survive and reproduce and get more intelligent species, dummy humans, to do their bidding. Now, let's look at viruses. There's a guy named Samuel Veissiere. He is an anthropologist and cognitive scientist who has pointed out the intelligence of coronavirus. Coronavirus is not particularly lethal. It has the R0 of 2, which allows it to spread like crazy, but it does not kill the vast majority of its hosts. Even with the most dismal estimates of mortality rate, it doesn't kill that many of its hosts. By comparison, if you look at something like Ebola, that has about a 90% mortality rate, meaning it kills virtually all of its hosts before they have a chance to spread the virus. That's not a great survival strategy for a virus. Now, I could take this even farther and say the coronavirus might have super intelligence. Bear with me while I walk through this with you. And remember, I am someone who believes plants have a level of consciousness, okay? So this might be tough for some of you to get, and it's kind of the stuff of blockbuster M. Night Shyamalan movies about natural selection, right? As I have discussed, I have zero fear of coronavirus because I'm healthy. Think about a mugger. If a mugger wants to mug somebody to make the easiest money possible, do you think they would mug a UFC fighter or would they mug grandma carrying her groceries? Which one is easier money? I believe this virus is working the very same way. Not only that, but what if the virus could actually make our species weaker through psychological warfare? Here we go. Well, people are running around buying up all the antibacterial products that they can find. I've already said you should probably use these things when you're out in public, but what does this do? Look no further than the fact that antibacterial hand soaps in recent years were banned from public schools. This is because antibacterial agents kill all bacteria, even the good kind that strengthen your immune systems. So all of the people currently bathing in Purell and Lysol, I was on a flight and watched people putting Purell on their faces. They are absolutely crushing their body's own immune system, the endogenous immune system. They are killing it. It's really awful. Okay, more on this in a moment with a couple distinctions. On top of that, everyone is going out and buying non-perishable foods. What does this mean? Processed, standard American bullshit full of preservatives with a long shelf life, 100% guaranteed to decrease the human immune system. Oh, and people are staying indoors and avoiding two things: sunshine, duh, most Americans are already deficient in this anyway, and the gym. No one's going to the gym. Most people are not like me. They do not work out from home. They must go to a gym. They need the motivation to go to the gym. They have to go to the place. This option is silly, in my opinion, but most people just don't know any better. So globally, people are staying home from the gym for fear of shared equipment, sweat, et cetera, et cetera. And again, missing out on the insane immune boosting benefits of exercise. So we now have a perfect storm of disaster for everyone. Killing all healthy microbiomes of the human body, decreased sunlight, decreased social connection and community, decreased physical activity, a diet full of processed foods and preservatives. I am telling you, if there were ever a time for an opportunistic virus to attack, it is right now. The health of our species is absolutely abysmal. Let me take you back to something I have said countless times in the last few years. America is just 10 to 12 years away from 100% of our GDP being spent caring for the sick. People ask me all the time, Justin, when do you think things will change? When will the mainstream wake up? When will everyone get healthy? And my response has always been the same. The mainstream won't change until the entire economy collapses under the weight of poor human health and they are forced to change. And it looks like we might have the catalyst for that change. Who knows? I don't hear anybody talking about how being healthy is a good idea. Nobody, none of the experts are talking about this. It's still all mainstream medical bullshit. Where's the pill? Where's the vaccination? Where's the cure for this terrifying thing? How about we stop being fat, sick, and nearly dead? That would be awesome, right? This thing is going to cost countless billions of dollars to fight. The markets have already lost trillions of dollars globally thanks to this panic. I really hate to say it this way, but we have a weak human species to blame for this madness. There is no gentle way to say that. So I want to dig into a conclusion here with you. Let me just take a peek at some comments. Curious about pregnancy. I would certainly be concerned. Stay home. And I have some recommendations for you here that's very, very important. Curious about risk for children under 10 with type 1 diabetes. Now you got a whole different ball game because type 1 diabetes, first of all, Megan, if you have a child with type 1 diabetes, we need to talk because everything the mainstream medical has told you is false. Type 1 diabetes, when caught early enough in children, can be completely reversed. It is simply an autoimmune condition that attacks the pancreas. It's literally that simple, and I can put you in touch with the experts. They will be expensive, and they will not be covered by insurance, but you should get in touch with me and work with them because, yes, anyone with type 1 diabetes, this is a severely compromised immune system. They might not be telling you this, your doctor might not know this, but type 1 diabetes is an autoimmune condition, okay? So big, big deal. Really curious on pregnancy and children risk. Jillian, if you go back to the beginning of this, just rewatch this. I talked about children. Children under the age of 10 seem to be almost immune to this thing, but the jury is still kind of out, so that should make you feel better. But if you're pregnant, it doesn't matter if that baby's at risk. You as an adult are at risk, and you need to take serious precautions to protect yourself from this. This is a big, big deal. Let me just dig in here. I'm gonna dig into conclusion, but I want to show you some of my tinfoil hat stuff because if you got a tinfoil hat, you might want to put it on. I'm going to share some stuff with you just because I feel like it. But first things first, I want to talk about what you can actually do realistically here.